So growing up, we would go visit my family in Dominican Republic. My dad loved to go on the visit the family, not just live in the city, but the ones that live out in the campo, in the countryside. So we go visit my auntie Lile. So she lived in this tiny little shack. And you can see through the walls, it was so like, just poorly put together. But it was her home. When we would go, we would just fill these massive cardboard boxes with stuff, food and clothes and sandals. And there was just so much that we were able to provide, but those things were band-aids for problems that weren't really being fixed.
It's too easy sometimes to insulate yourself from the challenges that other people are facing in the world, and I think that it's a really transformative experience for our students to go there, to see it, to live it, to carry water on their head, to grind grain by hand, and to realize just how much time and effort it takes to live in this way.
I think D-Lab just opens your eyes to so much of what the world is suffering and going through, which is hard because it can be hard to look at and see, but the truth is there are people who are experiencing it, and that's a lot worse than seeing it.
I think that there is a lot of engineers who want to be socially conscious and want to make impact with their work, and the missing element is always just finding this connection with the humans behind your work, and I think that D-Lab does a great job of bridging that.
So I've always been drawn towards engineering and math and science. I love the numbers, I love the problem solving. But at a certain point, I realized that while I enjoyed that as an intellectual challenge, I also wanted this human connection and this human element. And the kind of work that I'm doing now, it's very much about technology in some ways, but in many other ways, it involves understanding people, working with people, working across cultures, and things that have nothing to do with numbers at times. I ended up pursuing this career path, which was entirely different than something I had considered before. But I'm very thankful that I did make that decision. And D-Lab was very much a part of that, that pushed me and influenced me to take this kind of journey.
We really have students from every single major, and that's really exciting because it's a chance for them to work on an interdisciplinary project together and hear each other's voices and perspectives, and not stay trapped in that bubble that sometimes you get trapped in your major or your research program. We are unique on campus in that we try to expose students to other ways of making things, not just the most high-tech or the fastest way, which is a really important thing that sometimes they haven't been exposed to during their time at MIT.
One of the best parts of the job is we get to see the students have a transformational experience here. We hope that they are more grounded global citizens through their experience here.
This is a place where you go to use your hands to make things. So it's hammers and hacksaws. It is not 3D printers and laser cutters. And it is becoming more unique of a place at MIT because so many things have transferred over to the computer-controlled arena. I think D-Lab is a really important part of MIT's ability to live its motto of mens et manus, mind and hand.
So the mind, MIT is going to take care of that no problem. But when you get to actually take what you learn and put it into work and be able to take the skill sets that you've built and use them to change things, that's what's really inspiring and that's what's really game changing. This is my last semester and I'm excited to be graduating. But that's just the beginning of a whole life that I want to live, being able to give back, be able to take my degree and really use it in a way that D-Lab has prepared me to use it.